वीडियो में
स्वागत है।
और आज जो वीडियो हम लेकर आए हैं उसका टाइटल है
संडे ब्रंच विद रितेश एंड जिनेलिया देशमुख विद कामया जानी कर डिटेल।
वेल देख लेते हैं ये वीडियो, लेकिन उससे पहले
इस वीडियो के चैनल का ओरिजिनल लिंक जो है हमारे वीडियो के डिस्क्रिप्शन मिल जाएगा। सब्सक्राइब करें, लाइक करें, शेयर करें, फॉलो करें इनके चैनल को। उसके अलावा मेरे ब्लॉग के चैनल का लिंक और इंस्टाग्राम का लिंक भी हमारे वीडियो के डिस्क्रिप्शन मिल जाएगा। सब्सक्राइब करें, लाइक करें, शेयर करें, फॉलो करें।
चलिए देख लेते हैं ये वीडियो।
He is a total Marathi mulga. She is a bubbly Mumbai girl, and together they make a power couple in Bollywood. I particularly love watching their content on social media on marriage and relationships. Today, I'm going to be joined by Ritesh Deshmukh and Jinelia D'Souza on this very special episode of Sunday Brunch as I enjoy vegan food with them. Join me. Hi Ritesh and Jinelia.
Hello, hi, how are you?
Our audience and I, we love power couples, and so great to have both of you on the show, Sunday Brunch.
Oh, thank you.
It's a pleasure. Thank you so much.
It's a pleasure.
So thank you for taking our time on a Sunday to enjoy this brunch with me. I'm very excited. You know, Ritesh, they say happy wife is equal to happy life.
Ji.
So, ऐसी कौन सी चीज़ है जो Jinelia को बहुत happy कर देती है?
मुझे लगता है अगर मैं वक्त निकाल कर Jinelia को दे दूँ तो उनके लिए वही काफ़ी है। इट्स नॉट अबाउट मटेरियलिस्टिक थिंग्स, इट्स अबाउट कि आप वक्त दे दो, आप क्वालिटी टाइम स्पेंड करो, लेट्स प्लान समथिंग एंड हैव अ ग्रेट टाइम आउट, सो दैट्स इनफ।
ओके, और आप दोनों एक साथ, आई थिंक इट्स बीन क्लोज टू 18 इयर्स, 9 इयर्स ऑफ डेटिंग,
10 इयर्स ऑफ डेटिंग, ऑलमोस्ट 10 इयर्स ऑफ मैरिज नाउ।
वाओ,
सो इट्स ऑलमोस्ट 20।
Have things changed after marriage, Jinelia? This one's to you.
No, actually.
Has he changed, to be specific?
No, not at all. We're pretty much, I think, the same. Of course, every situation demands some kind of changes. Like, we were literally kids when we met. We grew up a little more, and then we became partners. Like, and then we got married. So there was that, you know, thing of a honeymooning couple, as you can say. Then we got kids, so at every phase, yeah, we have changed as individuals, but I think on the whole, we're pretty much who we are at the core.
But jab aap dono mile, at that time you were the chief minister's son. Ab ghar par minister kaun hai?
Prime Minister, President, Finance Minister, सब जी नहीं है।
Because वो उनके पास time नहीं है, so then what else?
Government संभालने के लिए। I'm like the outside support.
Actually, I love watching your videos on social media. Who is the creator behind all of this? किसकी ideas होती है?
मुझे लगता है क्या है कि जब शुरुआत हुई थी तब मैं TikTok पर video कर रहा था, like the engagement that I was getting with people who were watching it. फिर एक दो वीडियोस में Jinelia के साथ मैंने कर ली, उसके बाद टिकटॉक बंद हो गया, इंस्टाग्राम पर हम लोग आ गए, फिर उस वहाँ शुरुआत की, एंड देन Jinelia स्टार्टेड गेटिंग इन टू ओन ग्रुप। शी डिसाइड्स व्हाट शी वांट्स टू डू, समटाइम्स शी टेल्स मी यार ये वीडियो कर लूँ क्या, मुझे लगता है इसमें कुछ होगा नहीं, ये दिस इज़ ओके, एंड शी गो एंड पोस्ट, एंड आई एम लाइक अरे इसको 35 मिलियन व्यूज़ कैसे आ गए, मतलब यू नो देयर इज़ अ सर्टेन एंगेजमेंट दैट यू थिंक दैट विल गो इन अ सर्टेन वे, but there's certain conviction that she has and she does it her way and it's fine.
Did you both enjoy creating videos on
Yeah. I think we do. I mean to be very honest, we do enjoy it. It's a nice break. It's something to the pandemic has been tough, and you know, this is a nice way of doing it, and like Ritesh always says, the jokes are on us. So, you know, you're never really putting it out on other people, and when it's generally a husband and wife relationship, it can sometimes go very negative, but instead of it going negative, it can also be a lot of fun. You're two different personalities, you can't be the same, you know, so just laugh about it and have fun, I think.
So you both are foodies.
Jinelia loves all the chatarpatar.
I love chatarpatar. He likes food. We don't enjoy very greasy food or very, you know, one of those ki rich food. Our daily meals are like really simple, like, you know, and somehow things that I have learned once I got married to Ritesh was the Maharashtrian taat that you call it. It has like zavas and it has tetsa and it has. So for me, it is like, you know, we keep trying to get vitamin C and omega, and I'm like, this is in your food. So if you can just incorporate it daily, which my kids do, like they have a spoon of Jawas every single day.
Jawas is like flaxseed.
Flaxseed, yeah, sorry. Oh, okay. It's a flaxseed chutney, yeah. And thetsa, which is
mirchi ka, yeah, like with salt, yeah. And it's like an achar. Right?
Yeah, and it's literally just hand pounded, you know. So it's literally no oil and stuff. It's just something that you. So if you literally eat that, you have a balanced meal in any which ways. You don't need to have all these, you know, things that people keep talking about.
Yeah, I am just doing a Maharashtra tour for one of our shows.
Oh wow, fantastic!
And I explored so much of Maharashtrian food.
Yes.
You know, be it the sukka mutton, thetsa. Yeah. That's why I know of all of these things.
Yeah. There was a point in our life 5 years ago when we used to have non-vegetarian food, mm-hmm. and primarily mutton sukka and all those used to be the main yummiest dishes in
like Nadesh's house.
One of the best.
It's like their recipe. Like,
and when I used to go to Jinilia's, my mom used to cook these amazing chicken dishes and, you know, pork
sausages,
vindaloo and sausages. So now that we've become plant-based, so we give plant-based meals and ask them to just prepare the same recipe.
The same way.
So because it's our way to relive, because of course we love the taste of it.
Yeah.
What prompted you all to leave all of that one fine day and turn into vegans?
Ritesh turned first. Ritesh turned veg and I followed. I thought it would be okay because it was a manat, so we were clear we weren't going back, like, you know, in whatever way. I thought that I would manage because I had eggs and cheese and, you know, that was part of our diet and we were fine. And for us, vegetarian food at that point meant potato and paneer. That's all we knew. But then it started intriguing me, the colors and the food and just feeling so light. Turning vegetarian started making me feel great. So I was a very, very happy vegetarian. He missed his meat a lot.
हम लोग अमेरिका में थे, 5 साल पहले छोड़ चुका था, 4-1 साल बाद मुझे I was craving for my meat. I didn't know कि मैं कहाँ जाकर खाऊँ. तो अमेरिका में impossible burger है या beyond burger है, वो खाया मुझे लगा कि यार ये तो बेहतरीन है. और जिनिलिया वो burger लेके आई घर पे और मुझे बताया नहीं और मुझे बोला कि ये तुम्हारे नया डिश है ना, और लाइक ये नहीं खा सकता मैं. नहीं, इसलिए खा सकते हो क्या है, वो बर्गर को मिंस किया, अपने मसाले डाल दिए और उसका कीमा बना दिया, कीमा पाव मुझे सर्व कर दिया. और मैंने कहा अगर ये कीमा पाव मुझे मिल रहा है तो आई डोंट नीड टू गो टू द रियल वन, बिकॉज व्हाई डू आई लाइक इट, आई लाइक इट बिकॉज इट स्मेल्स लाइक कीमा, इट टेस्ट लाइक कीमा, मैं खाता हूँ तो मैं खुश हो जाता हूँ एंड आई एम फाइन विद इट. सो आई डोंट नीड टू एक्चुअली गो अहेड एंड यू नो किल एन एनिमल टू ईट द मीट दैट आई नीड टू. सो इट्स प्लांट बेस्ड मीट्स एंड उसी से इमेजिन मीट्स का जन्म हुआ.
Wow, this is very interesting and now I can't wait to try Imagine Meats. I don't want to imagine it anymore, so let's bring it.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we have chicken nuggets, we have Imagine sausages, we have the chicken sikh kebab, mutton sikh kebab, and we have the Afghani chicken biryani for you.
Okay, so this doesn't look like vegetarian at all. Are you sure about this?
No, we are pretty sure. Yeah. Like we spoke about sensory aspect, that first comes the look and the smell. It should smell like non-vegetarian, it should look like non-vegetarian.
It does smell like non-vegetarian, it looks like non-vegetarian.
Now we just have to taste and see how it goes.
Okay, and we should eat it hot.
We should eat it hot, yes.
Yeah. It's always about nice. Food is always good.
So which is the first thing you should start with?
Whichever.
I think.
Yeah,
try with nuggets. Let's try.
It's a shame
you're
with the nuggets. Please. The nuggets.
This tastes like non veg, like chicken nuggets.
Yeah. A lot of people, we did blind tasting and they couldn't make out the difference between chicken and this.
But what is it exactly? Is it soy or what is it?
No, so it's...
And what's the technology like? I mean, it tastes just like chicken or...
So I'll tell you. If you break it... See, you see the shreds?
Mm-hmm.
They're like chicken.
Mm-hmm.
So it's basically a mix of 2-3 soy proteins. We get our proteins from Berlin, America. There's a dry extruded process that we follow. It gives us texture. Then Jinilia has worked with chefs to figure out what kind of crust, what kind of flavor, because it's not only about the texture, it's also the taste, the aftertaste.
Whatever this technology is, it's really good. And I think all the vegetarians out there or non-vegetarians who want to shift to veganism or reduce their meat intake should definitely try this.
Let's please try. Let's dig in now.
What about kids? Because in India, milk is considered to be a very important part of the diet.
Which is such a myth, unfortunately. And it's so sad that people like me too, I've been a mom and I've given my kids milk initially and they would keep rejecting it. And then I went back to thinking that I as a kid would reject it. I didn't like it. I would throw it out at times. There's a reason, because it wasn't mother's milk, right? So we just force it down kids till they get used to it. You know, it's not, it doesn't become a choice or whether they like, and it also very often becomes a meal replacement.
You know, like, it fills you up, right?
It just fills you up.
Now we're going to do a quick compatibility test between the two of you. We've asked some questions to both of you individually. Now we want to see how well you know each other. Okay. So Ritesh, first to you, which is Janelia's favorite dish or her anytime snack that she loves eating?
Khakra is what is we are thriving on these days.
Recently it's khakra.
Khakra.
Very good. We're keeping a tab of this, okay?
Okay.
Janelia, you have to tell me which is Ritesh's favorite dish.
I don't know. It could be bhindi.
Not bhindi?
Well done. I'm so proud of you. I'm really proud of you.
Okay. So I wasn't a bhindi eater.
Great.
When I got married to Ritesh, I was like, what do I cook today? Bhindi. It's okay. What do I cook the next day? Bhindi. So he can eat bhindi every single day.
Yes.
Okay. Where was your first date?
Were you asking me?
Yeah.
Oh, you went to see Kabhi Khushi Kabhi Gham. So, yeah.
It's basically watching K3G in a theater.
Who was the one to ask the other person now?
Me. Because I wanted to watch K3G.
Alright. Okay, does Ritesh prefer traveling alone or in a group?
A group.
Group.
What about Janelia?
I prefer traveling with family.
Actually, it doesn't matter, but group is better.
She said family.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, that's group. It.
Okay. Does she like beaches or mountains?
Mountains, but I also like beaches, but I think mountains.
Nothing specific. But beach over a mountain.
Because of this recent trip. I said I don't know. I'm not too sure myself. I said, but like both.
More beaches and mountains.
Yeah, but now we've done so much of this trekking. It's a change.
Okay, never mind.
They were very upset that I've not said.
Yeah, because this mountain, so we were not on top of the mountain. We were below. We were watching the mountain.
Maybe next time we'll also go up.
True.
At the top. What about Ritesh? What does he prefer? Beaches or mountains?
I'll take beaches over mountains. But both are fine.
Mountains. Beaches?
Yeah.
Where?
कौन से माउंटेन में गए थे?
कौन से बीच में गए थे?
गोवा जाके है चार बार.
बीच में कहाँ थे? अब स्विमिंग पूल में.
अच्छा, if Ritesh could get free tickets to any place, where would he go?
New York.
दे.
तू मेरी बीबी है. बीच में मुझे डाउट आ रहा था.
Okay, and what about Janelia? Where would she go?
Anywhere where the family goes. Goa is one of my favorite places, so yeah.
I think she'll just say anywhere I go. I don't think there's a place that she'll say, I want to go to this place.
Who says that, right? Wherever the family is.
Yeah, family, yeah.
That's so sweet, yeah. Okay. Would Janelia ever try adventure sports, skydiving?
Yes, for sure.
For sure.
What about Ritesh?
Yes. I'm scared of heights, afraid of heights, but yes, I've done it and I've loved it again.
For sure.
He would too?
Yeah.
Okay. He said he's scared of heights, but skydiving is something he would do.
He would do, yeah. He's scared of heights, but he'll still do it. Yeah.
One thing that really annoys Ritesh.
Lies?
Late lies.
It's well done, yeah. Well done. I took lies over late. Incompetence was another thing, but
yeah.
I can't handle small lies. I didn't do this.
He cannot. You can say that I didn't do it, but if you try and cover up, because he already knows that you're covering up. So, and incompetence means is there's no place in his vocabulary. There is no place.
Wow. And one thing that annoys Janelia.
So I hate being dismissed, and I hate when you cannot plan your time well. I hate that.
Like, I think she gives a lot of instructions as to how it's to be done, and eventually when it's not being, makes it very simple and still things are not followed, and that irritates her. What did you say?
Being dismissed.
See? You forgot.
Because since I've not dismissed in a long time, I've kind of forgotten about it.
Alright, how does she react when she's angry?
I generally don't get angry, but if I'm angry, then I will have to finish that deal. So it has to get over for me. It cannot be something that go, like, you know, I forget about it. I'll never forget about it. It will go on till it's clear.
Yeah.
I mean, but I didn't say that, but yeah, I said that I can handle it for a while, and then after that
she has to blurt it out, like,
I have to. And then the history and the prehistory and the everything comes. And today doesn't know why it all came. Like, he's just like,
it starts from Mohenjo-daro.
Yeah.
And Harappa civilization, then Egyptian, then Greek, then Roman, then Indian.
Everything will come.
Okay, and how does he react when he's angry?
I go quiet. I'll go to sleep.
Goes to sleep.
Wow. Is that his way of venting out his anger? Just go to sleep?
He doesn't get angry 90% of the times. Like, not with me. The rest of the world is different. But he doesn't waste his time getting angry. If he's upset about something, he will go to sleep. He will wake up and pretend like nothing happened. Like, not pretend. He genuinely believes that there's no time to waste on something. Like, there have been times where we both had, like, you know, a little bit of an argument, and he's gone off to sleep. I'm still waiting to discuss, but he's sleeping. He'll wake up like, good morning, how's it going? And I'm like, but we've not discussed.
You have your emotions pent up. Yeah, he'll wake up and I'm going to discuss this.
He's like, but it's a new day.
हो गया कल की बात थी मैं समझ गया तुम क्या कह रहे हो अंडरस्टूड लेट्स मूव ऑन
दैट्स रियली कूल
व्हाई वेस्ट टाइम फिर उसको फिर से डिस्कस करो समझ गया आई गॉट
ही इज अंडरस्टूड ही डोंट वांट टू गेट इनटू इट
या यू हैव एक्चुअली स्टार्टेड स्पीकिंग मराठी आफ्टर मैरिज बट नाउ इट्स नाउ दैट्स द लैंग्वेज यू थिंक इन
समटाइम्स लाइक समटाइम्स आई मीन देयर इज नॉट ऑफ कोर्स इंग्लिश इज प्रेडोमिनेंटली इंग्लिश बट very often, like I don't think in Hindi at all. Like, it's always, you know, talking in Hindi because I have to at times. Like, it's not the language. But Marathi comes easier to me.
And
Marathi.
Also, we are sitting somewhere and someone will come, someone else's house, and, you know, and she wants to have a glass of water, green tea. She says, "Mala green tea kyun taka?" I'm like, "Why are you talking in Marathi?"
Yeah, I won't say. Mujhe mujhe green tea.
I heard you speak in Marathi.
Yeah. So that's what I say. Mala Marathi. You know, Mala. They keep saying, what are you speaking?
Let's talk about Maharashtra as well as a place. Your father was a chief minister of Maharashtra. This is the place where you were born. How proud do you feel of the state, of the region? You've been a Mumbai girl all in all.
Yeah.
So I'll take it from Janelia first. You know, when Janelia, which I really like, when Janelia's father and when Janelia was in school, and they had to write, you know, whether you're Bihari, Maharashtrian religion, he wrote Maharashtrian, and he said, "I'm born in Maharashtra. Though I'm Neil D'Souza,
and he was clear.
It was clear that I'm a Maharashtrian, and of course, rightfully so.
Ritesh was the only one who agreed with him. Then it was like, you know.
And we are culturally so rich that we need to celebrate it. Yeah. It's not that I'm proud to be Maharashtrian, but I'm looking down upon some other region. That's not true. I come from somewhere, and I have lived that life for the last 40 years, and I'm proud of that.
Ritesh always said that, you know, when I grew up, he used to tell me, I had the most amazing childhood. And I used to be like, you know, even I had an amazing childhood, like, right? So he used to be like, no, you know, the difference was that I had the best blend of both. I had rural and, you know, city life. Like, I had both of them. Pandemic happened, and we went there, and the kids were literally
which
on the
place
fields.
Is that?
The Latur, Babelgaon,
where he's born, right?
Yeah, where he's born. And I can't tell you how refreshing it is for me, a proper Mumbai girl who has not lived in small towns, but the warmth and the air and just being able to see fields and fields, and kids didn't want, they don't want to come back to Mumbai. It's unbelievable.
Which is your favorite place in Maharashtra to travel to?
It has to be Babagao. It cannot be anything else.
There's no replacement to that. And apart from that, I think there are these pockets that are beautiful. If you go to the Sahyadri Mountains and you can do trekking, and you have to find these lovely places. Even recently we went with Kanchi and Shabbir Aluwalia, who are of course extremely fine actors, but they took us on a tour to their Karjat farmhouse, and there was a lovely stream, no one around, just waterfalls everywhere.
I saw one video.
So that was literally in the stream, 5 hours. Like, these are things I wouldn't imagine myself. I keep telling Kanchi and Shabir, I could do it for two, but this 5 hours and the whole thing of how we cooked over there.
Especially in the monsoon, I think Maharashtra just becomes
something
beautiful.
Else. Something else. Yeah. Even Mahabaleshwar is such a beautiful place.
So now we're going to play a fun quiz with you both, which is about Maharashtra, since you both are proud Maharashtrians. Yeah. Name these Maharashtrian dish names. I'm going to tell an English version of this and you have to tell me the Marathi. Okay, the sweet flatbread.
The puran poli.
That's right. You like puran poli?
I love.
His son.
My son. His son. Tera bachcha nahi hai.
My younger son can have puran poli for breakfast, lunch and dinner.
I wasn't a big fan of puran poli.
Really?
Really.
I mean, I tried a lot of it recently.
And she, she loves it.
I love
and my kids love it.
Yeah, okay. So, all right. A Maharashtrian delicacy that looks like momos.
Modak.
Okay. Coriander cubes for a healthy snack.
Coriander cubes.
What?
Kotimbir
vade.
I'm thinking, cubes.
Yeah, cube, okay. Kotimbir vade.
Okay. Now, Maharashtra has a valley of flowers. What is it called?
What is it?
Kaas Plateau.
Oh, yeah.
Wow, well done, girl.
You recently travelled Maharashtra.
Yes, very
But we have a lot to travel in Maharashtra as well.
Like. And it has such beautiful... I have also been a Mumbai girl, all in all. But now I had the opportunity, like you mentioned, because of the pandemic, no international travel. Travelled extensively and discovered so many beautiful places.
Like Jinilia, me and our entire family, we want to do the Ashtavinayak. All the eight Ganpatis in Konkan and all of them. On a tour, on a three-day tour, we'll plan it somewhere.
Which is the second capital of Maharashtra?
Nagpur.
Okay, this is the highest peak of Maharashtra. I'm going to give you three options, okay? Harihar Fort, Kalsubai or Raigarh Point?
Kalsu.
That's right.
Yeah. Because Raigarh, I know that it's not the highest point.
Kalsu. One iconic restaurant of Maharashtrian restaurant in Dadar.
How can I not know?
One is Prakash.
Prakash, yeah. Prakash.
Yes, and his Panchikal.
Panchikal.
As well. Okay. Which fort was showcased in the film Bajirao Mastani and still exists in Pune?
Chaniwarwada.
Yeah, that's right. In this journey together that you both have had, which has been the happiest moment for both of you?
Happiest?
Happiest.
I think both of our children.
Yeah, there's nothing to beat that. I mean, though we enjoy each other, like for me, Ritesh is like my best friend, my companion. Like I don't need more people. Like when he's not around or when he's busy or when I can't tell him something, it irritates me. Not that, you know, it irritates me that I have to find another person to tell over you. Like, you know, that's the scenario. It's really never the sense of him and my mom. I'm very clear in that zone, but having children is just something that has bettered us, I feel.
We wish you all the best for your future projects. And I think we should finish this and not waste this delicious food.
Yep, absolutely.
But before we go, we also want to give you our hamper.
My husband's a vegetarian.
Really?
So we'll love to gift this to him.
Yes.
Then.
So here is our Imagine meets hamper for you.
Oh, okay. Thank you so much. Wow.
So
I quite like the dude here.
Yeah, he's Munna the goat.
He's Munna.
and that's Charlie the chicken.
Yeah. Okay. These are our founders with us. So that's Munna and that's Charlie.
So while I enjoy this delicious vegetarian meal with Ritesh and Janelia, you go like, share and subscribe to Curly Tales.
Thank you. I've overeaten when you all were talking.
I have finished.
इस कपल की बात की जाए तो वैसे एक कपल जो है वो मुझे बहुत पसंद है। जेनेलिया की बात को करूं तो उनकी मैंने दो तीन मूवीज देखी हैं, वो तो मुझे उन्हीं से वैसे ही बहुत पसंद है, लेकिन बहुत एक ये स्वीट कपल है।
बिल्कुल, और मतलब मैं काफी ज्यादा सोशल मीडिया पर इन दोनों को फॉलो करती हूँ, इंस्टाग्राम पर मैं डिफरेंट रील्स भी इन लोगों की देखती रहती हूँ। मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगता है और जो अंडरस्टैंडिंग का लेवल हम लोग को इस एपिसोड में भी नजर आया, मुझे लगता है कि वाकई में आपके बीच में हस्बैंड वाइफ का रिलेशन एक ऐसा होना चाहिए कि फ्रेंडशिप होनी चाहिए, क्योंकि अगर आपके हस्बैंड और आपकी वाइफ आप दोनों एक दूसरे के मुझे लगता है कि दोस्त बन जाते हैं ना, तो फिर आपकी लाइफ काफी ज्यादा आसान हो जाती है।
वैसे मैं अगर शादीशुदा कपल्स की बात करूँ ना, तो शादी के दो तीन साल बाद जो है उनके अजीब ही हालात हुए होते हैं। लेकिन मेजोरिटी के जो है अजीब ही जो है ना उनके जिंदगी के हालात हुए हैं। लेकिन मैं अगर इनकी बात करूँ तो वाकई जिस तरह वो दोनों एक दूसरे को जानते हैं ना, मेरा ख्याल है कि जो आजकल के कपल्स है ना वो इतना नहीं, एक दूसरे को टाइम भी नहीं देते, एक दूसरे को इतना जानते भी नहीं है। मैं अगर बात करूँ ना, मैंने ये चीज देखी है कि लोग जो है ना वो एक दूसरे के बारे में इतना इनके जानते हैं, लेकिन जैसे वो छोटी छोटी चीजें गुस्से पे क्या करते हैं, खाना कौन सा पसंद है, ये चीजें अगर मैं बात करूँ ना तो ये मुझे बहुत कम देखने को मिलती है।
देखो मेरी बात, मॉडर्न सिचुएशंस का एक बहुत ज्यादा फर्क होता है, ठीक है ना। अब अगर मिडिल क्लास फैमिली है, ठीक है, वहां पर प्रॉब्लम कुछ और होती है, खाने पीने की टेंशन होती है, वहां पर पैसा आना चाहिए इस चीज की टेंशन होती है, बिजली के बिल भरने है, बच्चों की फीस देनी है, और ये सारी, तो जब इतने साल गुजर जाते हैं ना, और फिर आने वाले टाइम में आपको सेविंग्स भी करनी है कि बच्चों की शादियां हो सके, ये वो सारे उनका बिजनेस सेट हो सके, तो जब ये सारी चीजें होती है ना, तो फिर पेरेंट्स बोलते हैं कि भाई, जब उनसे पूछा जाए कि भाई 10 साल बाद के मान लो कि क्या पसंद है आप एक दूसरे की पसंद है, सबकी बात नहीं कर रही है गहन में, कुछ ऐसे भी होते हैं जिन लोगों को वाकई में अभी तक पता होता है कि वो लोग एक दूसरे के बारे में क्या पसंद करते हैं, बट वो कहेंगे अनु सारा कुछ पसंद है, सब कुछ खा लेती
है।
तो मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि हालात जो है ना वो बहुत ज्यादा मैटर करता है कि वो किस तरह की सिचुएशन चल रही है। हर किसी की लाइफ जो है वो डिफरेंट तरह की होती है। बट एनीवे मैं इस कपल की बात करूंगी कि एक मतलब ऐसी इंडस्ट्री में होना जहां पर हम जैसे कहेंगे आप बहुत ज्यादा लाइमलाइट में रहते हो और आप उस लाइमलाइट में खो भी जाते हो, और उस टाइम पर आपका इतना ज्यादा इतनी अच्छी बॉन्डिंग होना, और मुझे एक चीज बहुत अच्छी लगी उनका डाउन टू अर्थ, वो इतने डाउन टू अर्थ हैं दोनों, और जिस तरीके से वो बता रही थी कि वो मतलब गांव में ही बोलेंगे ना कि लोग रहने के उनको बहुत अच्छे लगे, और ऐसा होता है आप शहर की जिंदगी से निकलकर जब गांव की जिंदगी में जाते हैं और अपने बच्चों को भी साथ में सिखाते हैं, तो बच्चों में भी वो चेंज जो है और वो लगाव जो लोगों के साथ और फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी, और मैं कहूंगी कि वो आती है, और वो बड़ा इंपॉर्टेंट है पेरेंट्स के लिए बच्चों को ये सब सिखाना।
अच्छा, वैसे मैं जेनेलिया की बात करूं, उनकी दो मूवीज मुझे बहुत अच्छी लगती है, एक जो है जाने तू या जाने इतना, और दूसरी जो है उसमें ये दोनों ही इकट्ठे हैं, जिसमें गाने बहुत ज्यादा हिट थे उस मूवी के, मुझे उस मूवी का नाम भूल गया है,
जिस गाना बड़ा हिट था वो उस मूवी का,
वो मूवी भी जो है बहुत मजे की है, उसमें ये अपने आप को किडनैप करवा लेती है ना खुद ही।
अच्छा, वैसे मैंने वो मूवी
नहीं देखी, उसमें वो ओमपुरी जी भी है।
अच्छा, बट एक और चीज मैं बोलना चाहूंगी फूड के बारे में, क्योंकि मुझे लगा ये एपिसोड जो था वो स्पेशली फूड को प्रमोट करने के लिए था, जो कि ऐसे लोग जो वेजिटेरियन नहीं है लेकिन वो वेजिटेरियन में स्विच होना चाहते हैं, तो वो सीरियसली मैं कभी भी सोचती हूँ आरविश के पाकिस्तान में भी ये वाला ऑप्शन हो, तो मैं 100% श्योर हूँ कि मैं स्विच कर जाऊंगी। मैं चिकन जो खाती हूँ ना, मैं वो भी नहीं खाया।
देखिए, आप भी बहुत सारे लोग जो है इस पे स्विच करना चाहेंगे, क्योंकि नो डाउट जो चिकन है या क्या नाम लेते हैं होती है ना नॉन वेज चीजें, उन्हें हजम करना बहुत ज्यादा मुश्किल होता है, फिर उनमें जो है चीजें भी इस तरह की होती है कि वो आपको क्या हैवी फील कराती हैं।
बिल्कुल, आप अभी डेली बेस की अगर हम बात करें, दाल खाएंगे, सब्जी खाएंगे, तो आप बहुत ज्यादा लाइट फील करते हो, ये एक फैक्ट है।
आपको बेशक सॉरी आपका ट्रिप कर दिया, अगर आप जो है ना दाल सब्जी पेट फाड़ कहते हैं ना, ये ज्यादा भर लेना पेट को, आप वो भी खा लेंगे ना थोड़ी देर बाद आप रिलैक्स फील करना शुरू कर देंगे।
हाँ।
लेकिन जो है ना अगर आप जो है नॉन वेज खाते हैं ना तो आपको तकरीबन 5-6 घंटे लग जाते हैं उसे हजम करने में, उसे बचाने में।
हाँ बिल्कुल, और इसीलिए तो कहते हैं रात के टाइम जो है नॉन वेज नहीं लेना चाहिए, बट खैर हम में से बहुत सारे लोग जो है इस चीज का ख्याल नहीं रखते। बट अगेन हमारे यहाँ पर प्रॉब्लम ये भी है ना कि ऑप्शन हमारे पास नहीं है, हम बाहर जाते हैं कुछ खाने के लिए हमारे पास कोई ऑप्शन नहीं है सिवाय चिकन के। मतलब हम अगर मोस्टली जो खाना है, इवन कि भाई वड़ा पाव तक जो है लोग कहते हैं कि चिकन की टिक्की होनी चाहिए, तो आप इसे आगे सोच लें कि यहाँ पर लोग क्या क्या मतलब खाते हैं और किस तरीके से। बट मैं कहती हूँ कि ये वाले ऑप्शन होने चाहिए, बहुत एक हेल्दी मैं कहती हूँ कि ऑप्शन। और बहुत सारी ऐसी वाकई में मिथ्स बनी हुई है, जैसे कि उन्होंने बताया दूध के बारे में बताया, फिर इसके बाद मैंने एलमंड्स के बारे में और जैसे कि जो अखरोट है उसके बारे में भी ये बात सुनी है कि हमेशा कह रहा था कि इनसे दिमाग बहुत तेज होता है, जबकि जो रिसर्च में पढ़ रही थी उसमें था कि जो ब्लूबेरीज होती हैं उनसे आपका अगर डेली बेस पर आप खाते हैं मतलब अपनी डाइट में उसको शामिल रखते हैं, और डार्क चॉकलेट इन चीजों से, एक और चीज है जो मैं भूल गई हूँ लेकिन इन चीजों से क्या होता है कि
आप
हाँ कॉफी बीन्स नहीं है तो इनसे क्या होता है कि आपकी जो मेमोरी है वो काफी अच्छी रहती है, आपका आपका ब्रेन काफी अच्छा काम करता है।
ओके, तो आप इसलिए डार्क चॉकलेट खाती हैं?
नहीं, मुझे तो वैसे पहले ही पसंद थी, बट ये कि मुझे मैं डेली थोड़ा थोड़ा एक मतलब कह रही कि एक बाइट ले लेती हूँ, मुझे पसंद
है डार्क चॉकलेट,
तो वो तो मैं अपने पैसों की खानी चाहिए, मेरे पैसों की नहीं खानी चाहिए, ये हमेशा
मेरे लिए डार्क चॉकलेट पता नहीं कौन खा गया, उसका मलबा मेरे पर पड़ गया। हालांकि इन्होंने मेरे कसम भी उठवाई है, मैंने कसम भी खा ली कि मैंने नहीं खाई, फिर भी मुझे यकीन नहीं आ रहा।
गाइस ओवरऑल काफी मजे की एक वीडियो थी, और सीरियसली जो फूड था वो बिल्कुल टेक्सचर ऐसा ही लग रहा था जैसे कि नॉन वेज, लग ही नहीं रहा था कि हाँ कि वो कोई ऐसा प्लांट बेस्ड है कोई इस तरह की। मैं कह रही हूँ कि जैसे जैसे टाइम आगे चलता जा रहा है वाकई में इस तरह की चीजें आती जा रही है, क्योंकि सबसे पहले मुझे नहीं पता था कि कुछ इस तरह का टेस्ट आपको वेज फूड में मिल रहा था, जैसे कि सोया चाप के बारे में चला, फिर उसके बाद अब प्रॉपर एक आपको मील मिल रहा है उस तरीके से, आपके पास ऑप्शन आ रहे थे, आई थिंक बहुत अच्छा है। और बाय द एंड हम लोग को ये मानना पड़ेगा कि नॉन वेज मतलब आप में से तो बहुत सारे लोग मानते हैं, हम लोग को ये बात माननी पड़ेगी कि नॉन वेज इतना अच्छा नहीं है, जबकि वेजिटेरियन फूड जो है वो वाकई में आपकी हेल्थ के लिए बहुत अच्छा है, और मेरा ख्याल ये बहुत अच्छा एक इनिशिएटिव
है। मैं अगर इस नॉन वेज की बात करूँ ना तो इसमें आपको हर चीज मिल रही है, आपको नगेट्स मिल रहे हैं, आपको जो है कबाब मिल रहे हैं, आपको
बिरयानी
हर चीज आपको मिल रही है, और टेस्ट जो है वो ऐसा ही कह रहा है
इतना खास नहीं खाते या कबाब कभी कभी बंदा खा लेता है, लेकिन बिरयानी ऐसी होती है जो कि आप बीच में एक मिनट जरूर खाते ही खाते हैं, तो मुझे लगता है कि ये बहुत अच्छा एक ऑप्शन है, और आई होप एंड आई विश कि पाकिस्तान में भी ये वाले ऑप्शन अवेलेबल हों, तो
लेकिन सस्ते में।
हाँ, नहीं, पता है कि अगर ये आ गए तो ये सस्ते में नहीं हो सकता।
हाँ, क्योंकि यहाँ पे सबसे बड़ा जो एक इशू है ना नॉन वेज में वो ये है कि अगर आपको यहाँ पे मिलेगा भी ना वो महंगा मिलेगा, जैसे हम ऑर्गेनिक प्रोडक्ट की बात करते हैं खासतौर पर फूड में बात करें तो वो आपको बहुत महंगी मिलेगी।
वेल गाइस, ये तो थी हमारी आज की वीडियो, आई होप आपको अच्छी लगी होगी, इसी के साथ हमारी
लाइक सब्सक्राइब शेयर
कीप अस इन योर प्रेयर्स।
बाय।